सोडियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट. नेक्स्ट सॉल्ट दैट वी हैव टू स्टडी, वी हैव स्टडीड सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, सोडियम क्लोराइड एंड वॉशिंग सोडा, दैट इज सोडियम कार्बोनेट. इट इज सोडियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट बिकॉज फॉर्मूला इज NaHCO3. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज सोडियम बाइकार्बोनेट. सोडियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट एंड सोडियम बाइकार्बोनेट बोथ आर सेम. रिएक्शन इज ऑल्सो सेम. वी हैव सीन द रिएक्शन फॉर द वॉशिंग सोडा. सो दैट सेम रिएक्शन इज डन फॉर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द सोडियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट. दैट NaCl प्लस NH3 अमोनिया प्लस CO2 प्लस H2O रिएक्ट्स टूगेदर टू फॉर्म NaHCO3, दैट इज बेकिंग सोडा. एंड सेकेंड प्रोडक्ट इज NH4Cl अमोनियम क्लोराइड. सो इफ यू आर आस्क टू राइट द रिएक्शन टू प्रिपेयर द बेकिंग सोडा, यू हैव टू राइट वन रिएक्शन. बट इफ यू आर आस्क टू प्रिपेयर द राइट द रिएक्शन टू प्रिपेयर द वॉशिंग सोडा, देन यू हैव टू राइट द सेकेंड रिएक्शन इफेक्ट ऑफ हीट. और दिस रिएक्शन मे बी सेपरेटली आस्क्ड, वॉट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ हीट ऑन द सोडियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट. सो वेन सोडियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट इज हीटेड, देन वी विल गेट थ्री प्रोडक्ट्स, Na2CO3, दैट इज द वॉशिंग सोडा और सोडियम कार्बोनेट प्लस CO2 प्लस H2O. सो दीज आर द टू इम्पॉर्टेंट रिएक्शन. नाउ सम यूजेस दैट वी ऑल्सो हैव सीन यूजेस, वॉट इज द यूजेस ऑफ द सोडियम बाई कार्बोनेट. सो सोडियम बाई कार्बोनेट वेन एडेड इन अ फूड स्टफ, इट रिलीजेस CO2 गैस एंड इट मेक द फूड स्टफ स्पॉन्जी. देन इट इज यूज इन द सिंपल टाइप ऑफ फायर एक्सटिंग्विशर. सो इन फायर एक्सटिंग्विशर बेसिकली वी वॉन्ट कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड गैस टू एक्सटिंग्विश द फायर. So to prepare that CO2, sodium hydrogen carbonate is used, and this sodium bicarbonate is also used to reduce the acidity of the stomach. Why? Because it is alkaline or it is basic in nature, and we know effect of acid is neutralized by the base. So this sodium bicarbonate is used to reduce the acidity of the stomach. Next salt that we have, that is the bleaching powder. Formula of bleaching powder is CaOCl2. Ca for calcium, O for oxy, and Cl2 for chloride. So name of the bleaching powder is calcium oxychloride. So we have two reactions for bleaching powder: preparation and reaction with acid. So first reaction, preparation of bleaching powder. So how the bleaching powder is prepared? So CaOH2 is calcium hydroxide, reacts with Cl2 chlorine gas. It gives a CaOCl2, that is the bleaching powder or calcium oxide, with the formation of water. This bleaching powder, when react with acid, CaOCl2 plus H2SO4, it gives CaSO4 plus Cl2 plus H2O. So this bleaching powder has various uses. We know bleaching powder is used as a disinfectant. It is used for disinfecting water, to make the water germ free. In rainy season we have some smell of the water. It is due to the adding of the bleaching powder in that water. It kills the germ present in that water. Basically bleaching powder contains chlorine gas. When bleaching powder is added in water, chlorine gas is released in less amount, and that chlorine gas kills the germ. We know that in swimming pools also this bleaching powder is used. So bleaching powder when added in a water releases Cl2 gas, and this chlorine gas kills all the germs present in the water. This bleaching powder is also used for the bleaching action in paper industry. Paper is made from the wood pulp. So to make the paper more whitish, or on the bleaching action on the paper is done, bleaching of action on the wood pulp is done in the paper industry, and in textile industry also bleaching action is done on the cotton. And this bleaching powder is also used to prepare the chloroform. Chloroform is used as the anesthetic agent, and it is also used as the oxidizing agent. Oxidizing agent means which provide oxygen. The substance which provide oxygen is oxidizing agent. So calcium oxychloride is used for preparation of the oxygen. So it is used as the oxidizing agent. It is also used to make the wool unshrinkable. Wool get shrink. So if we want the wool unshrinkable, then we also use the calcium oxychloride. So chemically it is calcium oxychloride, common name is bleaching powder, and formula is CaOCl2. Next salt that we have, that is the plaster of Paris. Plaster of Paris commonly called as POP. POP. And formula is CaSO4.5H2O. CaSO4 for calcium sulfate and half H2O for hemihydrate. So name is calcium sulfate hemihydrate. Hemihydrate for half molecule of water. So here we have two reactions for POP. One is preparation and second one reaction with water. So both are exactly opposite reaction. What is the product in first reaction? That is the reactant. So first preparation. So in preparation, basically POP is prepared from the substance called as the gypsum. So what is the difference between POP and gypsum? That is the difference in the water molecule. POP has half number of water molecules while gypsum has two number of water molecules. That is only difference. So when gypsum is heated, what is the formula of gypsum? CaSO4.2H2O. When this gypsum is heated, but it needs controlled heating. It needs heating only up to 100 degrees Celsius, or we can say 373 Kelvin. So when gypsum is heated at 100 degrees Celsius, then we get the POP. So reaction is CaSO4.2H2O. Then after 100 degrees Celsius heat is provided, we get CaSO4.5H2O, that is POP, plaster of Paris, and 3 and half means 3 by 2 means 1 and half number of water molecules get evaporated. So this reaction needs controlled heating. If more heat is provided, then that POP will also lose that half number of water molecule, and then that POP is called as the dead plaster. Then it does not have any use. So reaction of converting gypsum into POP, it should be done with controlled heating. Otherwise, it will get converted into the dead plaster. Now, second reaction is exactly opposite if water is added. So if we take the gypsum, if we take the POP, CaSO4.5H2O, and if we add the water, 3 by 2 water molecules are added, reaction takes place in that way, and it will get converted into gypsum, CaSO4.2H2O. So these are the two reactions for the plaster of Paris. Now this plaster of Paris has various uses. Plaster of Paris is used for setting the fractured bones in proper places in the hospitals. It is used for making toys, chalks, cosmetics. It is used for making cast for statues. It is used as the fireproofing material also. Then it is used in the chemical laboratories for sealing the apparatus to make it the airtight, for sealing the air gaps between the chemical apparatus so that air should not get leaked. And most important use, that it is used for the decoration of the roofs in the houses and buildings. So that is about the plaster of Paris. So this plaster of Paris also contain half number of water molecule, and gypsum contain two number of water molecule. So these water molecules are called as the water of crystallization. Here we have last part of the lesson, that is the water of crystallization. So every salt contains some amount of water molecule. And when these water molecules are present, then that salt contains hydrated salt, which is effective. If the water molecules are removed from that salt, then it is called as the anhydrous salt, and which is not that much effective. So what is water of crystallization? The water molecules which are needed to make the crystal structure of the salt, if we observe the salt structure, they are always crystalline. So non-crystalline structures are called as the amorphous. They are like powder-like. And salts are crystalline. So to make the crystal structure of the salt, water molecules are needed. That water molecules are called as the water of crystallization. And if water of crystallization is present, then that salt is called as the hydrated salt. And if the water of crystallizations are removed due to the evaporation, then that salt is called as the anhydrous salt. In our house also, we have baking soda. And if we keep it for the longer time, that baking soda is used for to make the foodstuff spongy. But if we keep it for the longer time, it cannot make the foodstuff spongy. Why? Because when we keep it for the longer time, the water molecules get evaporated. Then that salt become anhydrous salt. That does not remain that much effective. So there are many examples of the water of crystallization salts which contain water of crystallization, hydrated salt, and generally due to that water molecules, salts get color generally. So first CaSO4.5H2O, that is the POP, CaSO4.2H2O, that is the gypsum, Na2CO3.10H2O, that is the washing soda. These three salts are white in color. Then ferrous sulfate, FeSO4.7H2O, ferrous sulfate, that is the green in color, called as the green vitriol also. Then copper sulfate, here we have copper, CuSO4.5H2O. Each salt contains a specific number of water molecules. That water molecule for that salt that are fixed. So CuSO4.5H2O, that is the copper sulfate, that is the, which is blue in color. So copper sulfate solution is blue in color and it contains 5 number of water molecules. It is called as the blue vitriol. There are many examples of the salts which contain water of crystallization. Now if we have a salt which contains water of crystallization, which is a hydrated salt, and if we heat it, here we have activity in test tube, we have taken CuSO4.5H2O, that the salt which is blue in color, that salt, if we heat that salt, then what happens? That water molecules get evaporated, means CuSO4.5H2O, when it is heated, then 5 water molecules get evaporated, only copper sulfate remain. That first hydrated salt, it is blue in color, but if we heat it and water molecules are removed, only CuSO4 is remain, then that salt becomes anhydrous salt, which is white in color and which is not effective. So by heating, hydrated salt get converted into anhydrous. Similarly, anhydrous salt can be converted into hydrated by adding water in it. So that is about the water of crystallization. Fixed number of water molecule present in the crystal structure of the salt, that is the water of crystallization. And this activity sometimes asked for the exam, what is the effect of the heat? So due to the heat, water of crystallization get evaporated, but by adding water, again that salt can get the water of crystallization and it become hydrated salt. So this is the last part of the lesson.